Hi everybody, Alec Shaker here. Today I'm going to talk about SEO. This is the first video in the video tutorial series. Now you're going to want to watch all the way through this video because at the end of this video I'm going to give you some information that is just going to floor you because I'm going to tell you exactly what Google is looking for and what their formula entails. So stick around. Now, this talk is really about how to get found on Google and to capture more leads. So first, I want to define what search engine optimization is. It's the process of affecting the visibility of a website or web page in the organic or unpaid search results of Google, Yahoo, Bing, and the other search engines. So let me show you what that is. When you first do a search on Google, for example, in this case, I did a search on auto repair shops in Dover, Delaware. What you're going to see is a page something like this. These results here in red are ads. These are not organic results. So in other words, these are merchants that are paying to be here. These merchants that are at the top are paying more than these merchants that are on the side. This portion in green is the key. This is the organic search results. This is where most of the people click on the website to see what it is. And typically this will have 10 results. In this particular case, there's some results here which are from Google Places. These results are more and more common from Google depending on what your search term is. Typically, it's for services. I'm going to talk more about that later on in other videos. Now, I want to show you some statistics and why it's so important to be on the first page and a particular position on the first page. This is a chart from Chatika, which is an ad platform similar to Google AdWords. Now what you'll notice here is page one gets about 91.5% of the traffic. Page two gets about 5%, and all the other pages take the bits and scraps that are left over. So do you see why it's important to be on the first page? If you're not on the first page, you're missing 90% of the traffic. That's where almost everybody goes. So it's very important to be on the first page. Now, there's a second factor that's also important, and that is the placement on that page. So this is another chart by Chitika, and it shows you the importance of being in first place, second place, third place, etc. So if your website is ranked first on the first page of Google, it's in the first position, you're going to get roughly 32% of all the traffic that's going to that page. If you're in the number two position, you'll get about 17%. Number three, about 12%, and so on. So you start to see that the traffic goes down drastically after the sixth or seventh position. And then when you get to the second position, the second page, which is the 11th position and beyond, it becomes really low. So this is where you want to be. Any search engine optimization company that's doing work for you needs to be trying to get you in the first through the fifth positions, if possible. Now, why should you do SEO? First, with organic search results, all that traffic and all the leads and all the sales that you're going to get is absolutely free. Once you're ranked, you don't have to spend any additional dollars to get this traffic. You don't have to put ads, you don't have to do email campaigns, you don't have to go out and network. In other words, that traffic is free, it's passive. It's a fantastic traffic, and it ought to be part of your overall online marketing campaign. SEO should be an integral part of that, along with your content, your email lists, and all the other things that you do to market yourself. Now, I want to talk a little bit about how search engines work. By talking about this, it'll give you the perspective on why it is that we do what we do and what you need to do to get your website ranked. Now, the way search engines work is search engines are essentially a computer program. It's a computer program that searches the web for sites based on the keyword that you're using. So whatever keyword that you've entered, Google is going to go out and it's going to search the entire web for sites based on that particular keyword, and it'll return a list of sites that it deems most relevant to that keyword. So how does this work? Well, their mission is really to get you the best, most relevant results that are as precise as possible regarding what they think you are looking for. And the reason they want to do that is so that you keep coming back to them. So you bring them all your business, and they want you to click on their ads, because that's essentially how they make money. Whenever you click on the ads in Google, that's how they make most of their money. Same thing with Bing and Yahoo. They want you to keep coming back because you got great results and you got exactly what you're looking for. Early search engines didn't quite work this way. They were little more than listings of favorite websites or directories of websites. If you had a new website, you would enter your information in these search engines, and you, the visitor, would determine what category your website fell under. Or you would submit your website and a human being would determine what category or what lists your website should belong to. That's certainly not the way search engines work today. And this all changed back in 1996 when two guys working on their PhD at Stanford had an insight. What these two guys saw is that when they were working on their PhD thesis and when they were looking at other research papers, at the end of the research paper, there was a bibliography. Now, this bibliography has citations and references that support the information that they are presenting in their own paper. And the way it works in that world is that the more papers that refer back to a particular citation, so for example, if there's a bunch of other papers that are referring back to a particular citation, in this case, George Bibby, then George Bibby's paper becomes very authoritative because a lot of different people are referring back to it, meaning that this paper has some important information. It must have something very authoritative and important to say. So these guys thought, well, why not use the same concept for websites? So for example, why not rank the authority or importance of a website based on the number of citations that that website has on other websites? And this concept became known as PageRank. And the two guys who invented this concept are guys by the name of Sergey Brin and Larry Page. And as you might have guessed, these are the founders of Google. So now you kind of know the rest of the story. That's where the concept of PageRank came from. And that's how, even today, a large part of Google's algorithm is based on this concept. Let me give you an example of how Google works. If the entire universe of websites consisted of these 11 websites, this is how they would look to Google. The larger the circle, the more important, the higher their ranking, and the higher the page rank is. The smaller the circle, the lower their page rank is. And this number represents the overall page rank. So let's look at this. For example, B is the highest ranked website here. Now, why is that? That's because all these websites, almost every website in our small universe here, is pointing to it. You take a look at C. You notice with C that there's only one website referring to it, and this website is referring back. Now, the reason this is still considered a high PageRank site is because this particular website has very high PageRank and it's referring to it. So the way PageRank works is it not only looks at the number of different websites that are referring back to your website, but it also looks at the authority or how authoritative those websites are that are referring back to you. And that, in a nutshell, is kind of like how Google PageRank works. Now, why do I keep talking about Google? Because I want you to understand what a big footprint Google has. This tells you a little bit about the current search engine traffic. So about 2/3 of all the traffic in the world goes through Google. Bing and Yahoo are the other major search engines, and then the rest are 4 or 5%. Now, there's also some data supporting that Google is even bigger than this is, because data shows that people who go to Yahoo and Bing go to Google first. So I believe that Google is even more important than what this chart shows. So any SEO company that doesn't pay attention to Google, that knows intimately what Google's trying to do, is really not doing their job, in my opinion. Now, let's talk a little bit more about how Google works. Google catalogs the World Wide Web, and they use this by using what's called a spider. A spider is basically a program that crawls the internet. Spiders go to various websites. So if you have a website, a Google spider is going to come to that website. It's going to scan and assess the content of the pages. It's going to look at the code. It's going to look at all the tags, the meta tags, and what have you. And then it's going to take that information and bring it back to Google's mainframe computers. They index this content, bring it back to the mainframe computers. And in those mainframe computers at Google, Google analyzes all the websites. It's going to analyze your website using a very complex computer algorithm and formula to determine what your search engine placement would be. So it's going to put all kinds of weightings on different factors of your website. It's going to look at all the backlinks that you have, the social signals, and a bunch of other stuff that I'm going to talk about in a minute, and determine where your website should rank on their search engine. The algorithm is the key to cracking Google, right? So if you knew the algorithm, you could determine how to rank in Google. We do know that the algorithm is highly sophisticated. It's been significantly upgraded and honed in the past 24 months. I mean, it's been around for years, but it's been significantly upgraded. They're using artificial intelligence in addition to rote formulas and algorithms to determine where your website should rank. The precise formula is a closely guarded secret. It's kind of like the formula for Coke, which is only known by two people in the world. It's kept in a vault somewhere in Switzerland. And those two people who know the formula don't ever travel together. Google's formula is kind of like that. Sergey Brin and Larry Page probably know the formula, but there's not too many other people that know the formula. Even within Google, there's probably only a handful of people who know precisely what the entire formula is. Now, what if I told you that we have cracked Google's formula? What if I told you that I'm going to reveal what Google's formula actually is, and that using this formula, you can get your website ranked high on Google? Would you believe me? I'm going to reveal what Google's formula is right now. Here's Google's formula. This is not their mathematical formula. It is the factors that they use in ranking your website. So let me read it. Google rewards high-quality websites with compelling, relevant, and dynamic content that people stay to read or view, come back to over and over again, and share on their social networks, and that other good sites refer to. Okay? It's a little bit complicated, so let me read it again. Google rewards high-quality websites with compelling, relevant, and dynamic content that people stay to read or view, come back to over and over again, share on their social networks, and that other good sites refer to. Now, if you do all this for your website, I guarantee you that your website is going to rank high. Now, what I'm going to talk about in the next video is I'm going to pick apart each one of these elements in Google's formula and tell you exactly what that means, and tell you exactly what you need to do on your website to meet their criteria. So I'm going to talk about, for example, what is a high-quality website? What is compelling content? What is relevant content? What is dynamic content? How does Google determine whether people are coming back over and over again to your website? How does Google determine whether you're sharing it on the social networks? Which social networks make a difference? And by the way, Facebook might not be as important as you think. And how do they determine whether other good sites are referring to you? So stay tuned. Give me a call if you want the short answer, or stay tuned for my next video, and I'll tell you everything you need to know about Google search engines and search engine optimization. I'll talk to you soon. Take care.